I'm sure we've all used an e-commerce site where you click add to cart, you see a loading state, you update the quantity, you see a loading state, you delete the item, we see a loading state. And there's nothing wrong with this, but depending on how fast your server is, it could be a less than stellar UI experience. Wouldn't it be better if, for example, I click add to cart and it's instant? It right away shows my new item in the cart and I can update the quantity if I want. Also, no loading states, no loading spinners, delete the item, and it just magically happens. This is the optimistic UI, and I think it's been kind of hard to do and kind of hard to get right. And React has some new features, namely the useOptimistic hook, that make this way easier. Okay, so let's look at the code. I have this add to cart button, and inside it, it has a form. This form has a client action that gets called when I click on the button. And this client React action is gonna first call add cart item. This is the optimistic UI bit. So when I click on add to cart, this is how I'm immediately able to see this modal open. Now this add to cart item is coming from this context provider and this hook that I created, use cart. And inside of here, we're using the use optimistic hook from React. This hook takes in some initial state, so our cart, and then it gives us a function to be able to optimistically update that state. So we have one for updating cart items or adding cart items, and we can do that in this like reducer type pattern if you've seen that before. So that's how we're able to optimistically update that state, and then we're able to read that state using this same use cart hook and other parts of our application. But then we call await action with variant. This action with variant is just taking our React server action and it's adding one property that we want to use. So the React server action is called add item. And this add item is going to Shopify and it's actually saving that value to the database, to our cart. So we're able just to call that function from our client. We're able to import and use our server action and call that just like we were calling an external API somewhere else. The nice thing about putting this into this shared context is that we can reuse this code in other places in our application. So I have an edit item quantity button, so the plus and minus here, that do basically the same thing. I have the React client action, I optimistically update the value, and then I call a different action in this case. This one is update item quantity to do basically the same thing. So it feels really fast. And that's not only when I'm on fast internet, that's also if I go in and throttle to 3G here, you'll notice that it still gets that immediate UI update when I click on the button. Even though we can see in the network with this throttled and simulated latency taking about 2 seconds, still feels really snappy when I click on it. So React is really giving you these tools to take advantage of both the client and the server, kind of mix and merge them together in your application to make some pretty nice user experiences.